you've seen some gains in terms of share price movements. Once all of that begin to fall in place, the focus will come back to confidence and trust.
Time to market can be an issue, but if you consider that the business is not a short-term business, it's a going concern. So if you know that in 3 years' time you will be at X size and you need this much capital, then start a three-year journey. It's not the day before you want to start, you want to get into a market and you say, fine, let's generate the documents and get into the market.
That you think is very risky to the market that you think is safe for you. At that point, safety was top of your priority. And instead in that space, I cannot show you liquidity by definition as a private equity fund. Same thing as an infrastructure fund. If you give me money to build a bridge, I'll come back next week. See, where's my money? But that, how long does it take to build a bridge? Those kind of things.
Sorry, I mentioned about sanctity of contract. Your contract is as good as the intent of the person that's on the side of the contract. The difficulty in enforcing contract is one of the issues we see that we have in Nigeria as well. So everything has to do with, do we have the right institutions?
When you want to issue a note on the back of pool of assets like real estate, the quality of assets also talks to the quality, and that's the back to the point he was making on how the pricing of that asset. So if you are issuing rates and you pull out less than 40 properties that you go into, and you sell the back of that, you want to issue it based on the rental income that you expect to receive. So what we currently have is that we really don't have that quality.
Today, Ethiopia is fast becoming the manufacturing hub of Africa. And Nigeria is supposed to actually be that hub. But when the energy environment is not there, anybody can do. Like I said, capital will follow here in the values and get the returns. So infrastructure development, infrastructure system, not building your capital around the universe. There should be proper structure, proper governance. Tax regimes are another thing. We are confused in this country. A lot of people share with that. Global transition here and there. Government, local government, and people are not even government that are taxing everybody.
And I think the problem we have in Nigeria is that we don't have respect for capital. Be it foreign or domestic, just think we can treat capital. But capital is quite a number. I think last year we were in London together and we met an investor who had been in Nigeria for 30 years. I don't know if you remember what he said. He said that government officials should accessible when people want to see them. Last week we read about some people being somewhere not seeing investors. So you have to be serious if you want to attract capital. You have to know what that capital is. You have to be ready to deserve that capital. You have to be ready to do everything. I think until we start having people in government, leadership increases. You have people that are accountable to shareholders, people that embrace capital, people that know what it is to have goals, have milestones, be accountable. We're not going to get this sort of market.
Within the SEC system, we have a complex management framework where any agreed person can escalate complaints to say, look at how this was treated. They have special unit that will investigate this, and then if there is need, they can put it through their administrative proceedings, and then ultimately take a decision. And then where, by the end of the day, the person is still not happy, you can do a further appeal, you can go to the IST, you can go to the federal court, and then litigate all the way if you feel that the company has done wrong. But frankly speaking, it's the decision of the company that decides who would be a director and who can bring the necessary benefits.